Hello everyone, in this video we are going to understand the concepts of using a function in C programming by passing the arguments to the function that is called, right? So in the earlier video we have seen how to make use of a function, how we can call the function from the main. Now what we need to learn is that when we are calling the function, how can we pass certain information to the function that is being called. Suppose we are keeping the same programming example that we have performed in our earlier video, that is for adding the two numbers that are being entered by the user. What we need to do is, we need to pass the two numbers which the user has entered into the function that is being called for performing the addition, right? So in this case, we are going to call the function and we are going to pass the arguments to the function that is being called, right? So let us try to design this particular program of adding the two numbers by making use of the functions and by passing the arguments to the function that is being called. Okay, so we'll start off by including the header file in a C program, that is stdio.h. Then we will be having the main function. In the main function, quickly I will ask the user to enter the first number. Okay, enter the first number is what I'm asking the user to enter, then we'll scan it and we'll put it in variable a, right, and a. So as the rule of C programming says that we need to declare the variables before we make use of them, so we have to define a and b as the two variables of the type integer, and I'm going to store my first number that I'm entering in a, and similarly we are going to ask the user for entering the second number. Enter number. Okay, and in this case we are going to put this in B, right? Now we have to call a function called myAdd, which is a user defined function, and we'll pass the values of A and B to this function. So this is how we can call the function called myAdd, and in case we want to pass in certain values, we can pass in like this. So in case I'm willing to pass the values of variable a and b, I'll just separate them with a comma. So you write something like this: function name within the brackets, argument 1, argument 2, that you need to pass to the function that is being called. In this case, the function that is being called is myAdd. Okay, so we have to declare the function, we have to define the function body, and the best place to do that is to do it before main, right? So we'll do it over here. Void myAdd. Why I'm writing myAdd function over here with the return type void. So it's like the void is being mentioned over here, so there's no return value, right? So the function is not going to return any value, and this is a case where we are calling the function by passing the values of the argument, but we are not getting any value returned from the function. Okay, so instead of keeping these parentheses empty, what we need to do is now to have two variables, int x, and there is another variable of type integer which I'm declaring as y. Okay, so int x comma int y is what I'm writing over here. So now try to understand what we are going to have over here when we call this function called myAdd and we pass a and b values into the function. What will happen? This value a will be mapped into variable x, and this value b will be mapped to the second variable which we are declaring over here, that is variable y. Okay, so when this function call is going to be made and the values of variables a and b, they will be sent to the function that is being called, that is myAdd. X will be equal to a and y will become equal to b, right? So this is what is happening when we are calling the function and we are passing in the arguments, right? So the values of variable a and b, the parameters a and b, that is being passed the function called myAdd, and the mapping is going to take place. X will become equal to a and y will become equal to b, right? So within this function we are going to declare a local variable, let us say z in this case, right? And we'll write z is equal to x plus y, right? So z will be the addition of x and y, and indirectly when you see it, x has a value and y has b value, so z is a plus b. This is what is happening over here, and now we have to just print the result. So we will write printf, the addition result is %d comma z. This is what we are going to write. So now you are going to print the result, which is stored in z variable, right? So now you are not making any variable as global. A and b are the variables which are declared in the main function. Z is a variable which is declared in my add function, and when we are calling the function, we are passing the parameter values a and b to the function that is being called over here, that is my add. So x will become equal to a and y will become equal to b, and we will be able to make use of x and y variable in this function, and we'll perform the addition, and the result will be stored in variable z. Now in the next line, that is line number 13, we are printing the addition result, which is stored in variable z, right? So this is what is happening in this code. This is a classical example of function call and passing in the parameter values without having any return value from the function that is being called, right? So what we need to do now is to save this program, and I'll write my add 2 as the name of this file, and the extension will be .c, and we are going to save it. We are going to save it like this in the same folder. Now we have to compile this code to see whether there is any syntax error or not. And now when we are running this, we get zero error and we get zero warning, right? So there's no error and there is no warning in this code. The code looks perfect in terms of the syntax, right? So let's see whether it gives us the right result or not by running this code. When we run this program, see what the first message comes on the screen. Let us enter the first number, let us say 45, enter the second number, let us say 65. When I add 45 with 65, I'll get 110 as the result, okay? So when I hit enter, you see that now you get a result on the screen. Addition result is 110. So now this is an alternative approach of writing the same program of adding the two numbers, but in this case we are making use of the function and we are calling the function by passing the parameter values into the function that is being called. And you can note that there is no return value from the function. This function myAdd is not returning any value, right? So the return type is still void. It is not returning any value to the function from where this function call has been made, right? So in the next video, what we are going to see is the implementation of the same program, that is the addition of the two numbers, where we are going to call the function, we are going to pass the arguments to the function that is being called, and we will get the return value from the function. I can't wait to see you in the next video. See you there.